fucking half moon when I heard that kid. But in this word, God responds in great anger. And throughout the Bible, when his mercy is trampled on. Yes. God used children born and raised in the wilderness. Can't you see it happening today? God is using the young people whose parents didn't even go to church. So you and I get regular reminders. Lots of reminders. Some of us don't want to go to the mailbox because and you certainly don't answer a call that doesn't have my head.
Neighbor.
I don't know what you want.
But I want God's favor. Christians today have just become lazy that we don't want to work it. We got to work it. It's more than just coming to church. You got to work this thing every day. Have you ever thought about the concept of having God's divine favor flowing in your life? Favor is talked about throughout the Bible. And in addition to our scripture for the morning, let the favor of the Lord of divine favor was and still is a working concept. So in Webster Dictionary, the definition of favor includes these: friendly or kind regard. Favor includes goodwill or approval. Approval that you don't deserve. It's favor is when people just like you because they like you. It's unfair partiality. Is favoritism, attractiveness, to be partial to, prefer to help, assist, to do a kindness for. It's like endorsing. To be favored means to be regarded or treated with favor, provided with advantages, specially privileged. Specially privileged. Oh, Lord, just think about that. We can ask God to give us as Christians, as those who say we believe in Him, we can ask God to give us special privilege. Oh, Lord, we can ask God to give us special favor. God wants His divine favor to just flow all over our problems, and we'll look around and they are disappearing around us. Listen, when God's favor is flowing in your life, you can't explain it. You can't explain favor. People be jealous and mad at you, but favor ain't fair. It's favor. You don't get mad at somebody else because they got favor from God. And things seem to be going good for them, it'll go good for you if you ask for it. Stop being jealous and just ask for it. Say, Lord, I want some of that right now. Divine favor. Listen, when God's favor is flowing in your life, life just amazes you. You never thought that things would be so good for you, knowing who you are and where you come from. Oh, good God, Mike. The problem, however, is that most of us don't give credit to God for God's favor because we think we did. Help me out in the name of Jesus. God's favor. You tell me who does God's favor. From God's favor will cause people to go out of their way to bless you without even knowing why they're doing it. Talking about favor now. Talking about favor. And the more you're blessed with God's favor, God knows that you're the kind of person, the more He blesses you with favor, the more you're going to bless somebody else with favor. Listen, God wants to give us His favor. He's a loving, powerful, and kind God. God loves praise and glory, but we have to believe that God desires to give us special treatment. God wants His divine favor to just flow all over our problems. God wants His divine favor to just flow all through our lives. Let me tell you about God's favor. God's favor promotes you. It's the story of my life. It's the story of some of y'all's lives too, but you think it was you and it was never you and you heard that.
I got a promotion because I was qualified.
No, you did not. Some of y'all might have got a promotion because you played a game. God will open doors that people have closed in your face. I said God can do it. Y'all be giving God glory for that. God did it. God's favor will protect you even in your sin. Now some of y'all, you know what, some of y'all don't need to be here today. Some of y'all so bad, y'all just need to be in jail. Some of y'all don't even know that it's God's favor protecting you from all the mess you get yourself into. How about people who've been in jail? They got caught.
Little egos, we stop thinking we so much and we so bad and we so tough and we can have.
to know that God's favor was working. And if you don't understand that, you need to start asking and declaring what you want. Say after me, I want God's favor. Nothing like favor from God. Oh, child of God, don't you want divine favor in your life? When you come, you can have it, you can have it, you can have it. If you love the Lord, all you need to do is remember what God says about things and confess it and ground it in your spirit. Confess when you wake up in the morning. Let the favor of the Lord be upon you today. You gotta start talking it. You can't just come to church all hard and all that. You got to work Christianity. You got to work. Somebody said, you know, Christianity has failed. My preacher, when I was little girl, he said, no, it hasn't failed. It's never been tried. You got to work your faith. You can't just say you love God and then act like you don't. You can't just say, I believe, and then go out and do something that ain't holy. Somebody else. Go out and think that you've got all the power. You can't do that. You have to have faith in God, that God, I'm going to tell you something that you haven't heard before. God will make you special. You've been talked about, mistreated, and abused, and lied on. So is Jesus. You've been frowned on, laughed at, people rolling their eyes at you. I've been through all of that. I just say, Lord, I need your divine favor. And then you look up at the people who was rolling their eyes at you that had to go and get some glasses. Oh my God. They're rolling me now. I can't even see them eyes. We have not because we ask not. And you in trouble when you mess with one of God's children who has asked him for divine favor. Lord, please give me divine favor. You say, Lord, I want to walk out the door and a miracle's waiting on me. Lord, I want to wake up in the morning and feel like a brand new person 30 years younger. Lord, to flow from God. God to you and from you to others. That's who God is. His character is to give us special treatment. It ought to be a reason that people want to be a Christian. I hear young people saying, I don't want to be no Christian, no more Christian, just empty. Ain't no miracles happening, ain't no wonders going on. They act like the dead, they ain't got no life. Nobody's attracted to being a Christian no more, because we Christians don't even know that one of the things we can do is act for the favor of God in our life and let people see it working, and they go, whatever you got, I want that. And so first, we expect things to flow from God to us and to others. Second, you give other people favor. Like God gives you favor, even when they're not nice to you. You know, it's just not easy being a Christian. Check your legs, it ain't easy being a Christian. Look, this serious, it ain't easy. But I really kind of Compton. So Compton gives me more protection than I'm from Compton. Gives people attention. And I'm from Compton. God will favor me by putting me in Compton. But a lot of things that Compton people do like me are not holy things. So I have to ask for God to clean out some of that. Yeah, because God wants us to be balanced. He doesn't want us to go off the wall, or, and, you know, he don't want us to be too loud or too quiet. Where's the balance? Where's the balance? Where's the balance? So the balance is, sometimes I have to go compliment on the devil, not people. That's what I had to learn. Because I don't fight against flesh and blood. I go Compton on the enemy. Oh, yeah. Oh, you ought to see me at home. There's something wrong with her. You got to act this thing. You got to visualize this thing. As a Christian, you got to know you have something that the world needs to see happening in your life. There's something we need. And we need to say it over and over. Say after me, God favors me today.
God favors me today.
I am a success today.
I am a success today.
He makes my face to shine upon me today.
He makes his face to shine upon me today.
Erase. He makes his face shine upon me today. Thank you, Lord. The Lord is gracious to me today. When we make good things happen for others, God will make good things happen for us. Somebody said amen. So, child of the Most High God, I want you to believe this morning that God has the ability to influence anything or anybody for your good, and that his divine favor is on your life supernaturally. I'm talking about believing in the supernatural.
Take our work and give us a return on our investment like none other.
overflow.
God can take your something and make it overflow. God will take our sorrow and give us joy. We can't explain. God will take our weakness and give us strength. God will take our effort and give us success. God will take our commitment and give us satisfaction. God will take our tiredness and give us rest. Blessings.
Through Jesus, we are complete in the favor of God. So beloved. It's good. It's a wonderful thing. Blessings overflow. And it's all for you and you and you. Expect that. Stop worrying about what's happening to you in the natural. And get busy. Something good for me, that's all I know. That's all I know. Whenever it comes, I'm happy. But I know that it's coming, because I'm a child of the Most High God. I'm a king's kid, and God, you treat your children special. Don't get upset with anybody when you see them getting names, because yours is on the way. Sometimes you get to be hating on people, hating on people, hating on people. But they've done some things that you didn't do. They love out of the way you don't know how to love them. Don't hate on them. Appreciate them. Remember that when you see somebody else in miraculously blessed, and you're happy for them, I guarantee you yours is on the way. Because the test that you pass or fail is how you feel for somebody else when they get blessed. You have to love to see people blessed. I love to see people blessed. And the spiritual realm, oh my God, what God can do. God's favor. I have seen some preachers who just have enormous favor with God. I'm so happy for them. I'm humbled when I go into their churches. I'm humbled. I can see that no one person could have ever done it. God's favor. We need to pray for God's favor on this city. We need to pray for God's divine favor on this church. God said, go and make disciples with all you want to do what God tells us to do. How do you expect God to give you favor, keep you special when you won't even do what he asks you to do? It don't cost you nothing. It don't hurt you. You just don't want to do it. Go and make disciples of Jesus Christ. It's the command, not the suggestion. Lord, we need divine. Do what it is you're telling us to do. On my calendar, I have spent 3-4 days in the city of Lancaster, in the city of Palmdale. Just going around meeting people. Just finding out what that area is all about. Just talking to them about this church. I get the greatest excitement about that. Because I love being obedient to God. So Cindy, I need a prayer card for you. Go to the hotel at the expense of performing in our house. As I represent doing God's work, we can't just
sit here and not go out.